Hello. Our devotion for today is entitled Coming Soon, and it is taken from the Gospel of John, chapter 16, verses 16 through 22. Jesus said, "A little while and you will see me no longer, and again a little while and you will see me." So some of his disciples said to one another, "What is this that he says to us? A little while and you will not see me, and again a little while and you will see me, and because I am going to the Father." So they were saying, "What does he mean by a little while? We do not know what he is talking about." Jesus knew that they wanted to ask him, so he said to them, "Is this what you are asking yourselves? What I meant by saying, 'A little while and you will not see me, and again a little while and you will see me'? Truly, truly, I say to you, you will weep and lament, but the world will rejoice. You will be sorrowful, but your sorrow will turn into joy. When a woman is giving birth, she has sorrow because her hour has come. But when she has delivered the baby, she no longer remembers the anguish for joy that a human being has been born into the world. So also you have sorrow now, but I will see you again, and your hearts will rejoice, and no one will take your joy from you." In the Gospel of John, chapter 16, verse 16, it is written that Jesus said, "A little while, and you will see me no longer, and again a little while, and you will see me." You've probably heard that before, especially today, because this sentence is repeated three times in our text. Clearly, this is something that Jesus wanted to stress. We know that he used the same teaching method as other teachers did back in the day, for they constantly repeated important things so it would sink into people's consciousness and stick in their memory. But what was so important about this lesson? What does Jesus mean? First and foremost, he was talking about what would happen the next day when he would die. He would be separated from his disciples for a little while. But then, 3 days later, he would rise up and they would see him again. They would be very distressed, just like a woman who bears children on Good Friday and on the Saturday after. But their joy would be even greater on Easter Sunday morning. And no one would be able to take that joy away from them. But Jesus alludes to something more here. The day he would leave them and return to his Father in heaven. Then they would no longer see him as they would during the 40 days after his resurrection. Jesus is talking about his ascension into heaven. Yet even this separation would be for only a while. Then the disciples would be able to see him forever. A little while is, in other words, the time until Jesus' second coming. It might seem strange to call it a little while, since it's now been 2,000 years. But it's a question of measuring time by God's own standard, as it fits into his plans for the whole course of the world. It is a little time in comparison with the time that has passed since creation. And it's an infinitely small amount of time in comparison with everything that awaits us in eternity. It will also be a little while for every individual, a few short years, until we meet Jesus face to face as heirs to his kingdom. It's a common and disastrous mistake to think that Jesus' return is a long time off, that we have plenty of time to fix all of that stuff about God later. It's human and understandable to feel that times of our difficulty, times of our suffering, last a long time. Time goes by very slowly when we suffer. Yet the Apostle Paul says that our affliction is momentary and weighs little. He could say this because he sees suffering in the big picture. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 17 writes, "For this light momentary affliction is preparing for us an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison." That's the correct perspective. It shows us that it really is only a little while. Let us pray. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who sacrificed himself for us on the cross and 3 days later ascended, was risen from the dead. And Lord, now you have allowed him to ascend back into heaven, to be at your right hand until the day he comes to rescue us. Lord, you have said that this is going to be a little while, and we ask that you would sustain us and keep us in the faith until the time arrives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God's blessings. I'll see you next time.